People Fit Health and Fitness, this is Total Body Toning. Always consult with a physician before starting an exercise program. We have three standing exercises that we're going to be doing. The first one's a leg exercise. So we're going to start, I'm going to give you two choices. One, this is going to be the more advanced version, then I'll give you a modified version. More advanced, we're going to do a stationary lunge. So we're going to face towards a wall, sideways to a wall, or you can be in free space if you want. I'll leave it up to you. I'm going to face towards a wall though. Take a long stride. We're just gonna go up and down. You can go very small like this. You can go much deeper if you're comfortable with that. And we're just gonna stick with one leg out in front. Here's the alternative. You're just gonna do a set of squats. If you'd rather just do a set of squats, you can. All right, so let's start with the right foot out in front. Left leg goes long stride. And here we go. We're going up and down, or you can just do a round of squats. That would be your modified exercise. We're gonna do 30 seconds each leg. We got three more. Two. Last one. All right, we're gonna stand all the way up. We're gonna change the feet. We're gonna go long stride again. And here we go, up and down, nice and smooth. Go as deep as you feel comfortable. Even if it's just a little bit, you can keep them real shallow or you can go really deep to the ground. That's up to you. Obviously deeper is gonna be much harder. Three more, two, last one, good, and we're gonna stand up. Okay, next one's gonna be a hip exercise, two different parts to this exercise. First one, we're gonna do a standing hip abduction, so you stand up, you can hold on something or face towards something if you want. It's gonna be a side hip abduction, so you're gonna stand up tall, kick your leg to the side, then what we're gonna do, so the first part's to the side. Second part is going to be high knee. So we're going to go to the side, high knee, to the side, high knee. Okay, so while we start with the right leg, we'll do first. We're going three, two, one. Here we go. Out to the side, high knee. Out to the side, high knee. We're going to do 30 seconds each leg. Don't lean back when you do this. You don't want to lean sideways or lean back. Try to work on your posture. I'd rather have you hold onto a wall if you need to. One more of each. Okay, take a pause. Let's go with the other leg. Here we go. Kick out. Kick up. Kick out. Knee up. Try to get your foot way out in front when you do the knee up part. We got one more of each. One. One. Okay. Third exercise. We're going to do an upper body on this one. So we did legs, hips. This is going to be a tricep for the back of the arm. We're going to do a kickback. So you're going to want one weight, probably 5 pounds or less. If you really want to challenge yourself, you can go 8 pounds-ish, but probably with 5 pounds or less. We're going to go right hand first. You can lean forward on something, a chair, a table, anything like that. You can also use your leg. You can use your hand or your forearm. You just want to have a nice forward lean. We're going to pull the elbow up. And then we're going to extend the weight back. Keep the elbow nice and still. All right, so let's start with the weight in the right hand. We're going to get the left foot, left hand up in front. And we're going to pull the elbow up. And here we go, extending back. The more you're facing the ground, the better it is. You're going to get more tricep involved. It's going to feel a little more comfortable on your shoulder. So lean nice far forward. Keep your elbow nice and still. We got two more. Okay, stand up. We're going to change hands. We're going to change the feet. All right, we're going to go right hand forward, right foot forward. Left hand has the weight. Good forward lean. Elbow tucks in and up. We're going to extend the weight back. Here we go. Nice and slow. You don't want to be swinging the weight, right? Nothing quick. You want to do it slowly, nice slow pull. The less the elbow moves, the better, okay? Just hold that rhythm. This is another 30 seconds. We're doing 30 seconds on each one in this section, in this series we're going to be doing. Let's do three more. Two more. Last one, and then we'll stand up. Fine, you can get rid of the weight. Let's go through that series. We're gonna do three rounds of those three exercises. So the first exercise we did was a stationary lunge. You can put either leg out in front. I had you do it specifically a certain way the first time, but now that we did it, one, pick either leg. We're gonna do both sides. Your alternative, again, would just be a set of squats if you wanna do squats. You're gonna take a long stride. Eyes up, chest up, and we're gonna drop down. Here we go. Up and down. You can go really small, or you can go really deep with the knees if you want to. I'll leave that up to you. Okay, keep going. You're already halfway through this series. You got 15 seconds to go. Five, four, three, two, one, stand all the way up. We're gonna take about 10 seconds, but I'll let you get your other foot out in front. Long stride again, eyes up, chest up. And here we go. Straight up, straight down, as deep as you feel comfortable with. Go ahead, we've got 30 seconds here. Let's do three more of them. Here's one. Here's two. And three. All right, stand up tall. Take a few seconds. Next one, if you want to hold on to something for some balance, you can. You don't need to. Just make sure if you're kicking, you're not tilting a lot. You're not leaning back. You're going to stand up tall, hold your core tight. I'm going to face the wall, but I'll leave it up to you if you want to or not. Same idea. Pick either leg. We're going to kick out, and then we're going to go high knee up. So let's go in five, four, three, two, one. Go ahead. All right, we got one more of each. Okay, pause. 10 seconds before we do the other one. Here we go, good posture, tight core, don't lean. Here we go, kick out. Knee up. Kick out. Knee up. One more of each. Alright, and you can take a pause when you're done each one. Alright, we're going to go back to our third exercise. This will be our upper body. This will be our tricep, back of the arm. Again, you can use anything. I'm going to use a chair, but you can use a chair, a table, a couch, anything. You can use your leg. You can do hand or forearm on the leg. You want your left foot, left hand forward on this one. Let's just all do the same one on this one. Right hand's going to hold the weight. Left foot, left hand is forward. And we're going to pull the elbow up and extend back. Here we go. Okay, nice rhythm, slow pull, not a quick swing. We don't want to swing the weight, we want to pull nice and slowly. You need three more. Two more. Last one. Stand up, change hands, change your foot position. Same deal, good forward lean, nice flat back. Go ahead. 30 seconds of sun. Two more of them. All right, stand up, lose the weight. All right, third round, then we'll take a break and then we'll do some ground exercises. So a third round, you have squats as an alternative, or you can do the stationary lunge. Stationary lunge, put one foot out in front. Take a long stride, eyes up, chest up, and here we go. Straight down, straight up. Only go as deep as you feel comfortable. Hold that rhythm. 30 seconds. Make sure your front knee is not going in a forward direction. You want to keep that front knee nice and stationary. Don't want to be lunging in a forward direction. We want to be lunging down just to help protect our knees. We've got 10 seconds to go. Why don't we do three more? Two more. Last one. All right, stand up, take 10 seconds, change your feet. Let's get the eyes up, chest up, long stride. And here we go, straight down, straight up. We're good, keeping the knee back. You got 10 seconds, it leaves you time for three more. Go ahead, three. Two more. Last one. All right, stand up tall. We have hips to go. We have side hip, front hip. This is our side leg kick, it's side hip. High knee, front hip. Don't lean sideways, don't lean back. You wanna stand up tall, tighten your core. All right, take a leg, you can hold on to a wall if you want to. And here we go, out to the side, and up. Out to the side, and up. Try to keep your toes facing forward. That's something also you can focus on. You want your toes to always be facing forward. Don't kick out to the side with the toes. Keep them facing in the forward direction. 10 seconds. One more up, one more out. And you can take a pause. All right, we're gonna switch to the other leg. We're going 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Here we go, tight core, side kick, high knee. Side kick, high knee. Now hold on to the wall if you feel like you need the balance support. Ten, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. You got one more of each. And when you're done, one more of each. If you stand up tall, grab a single weight. We have one more round of our tri-step kickback. Tri-step kickback. You can do either hand. You just want our opposite foot, opposite hand up in front. All right, so I'm going to start with the right foot. This round, I'll let you pick whichever side you want to start with. Good forward lean, nice flat back. We're going to keep the elbow close to our side, pull the elbow up, and let's extend the leg back. Go ahead, 30-second round, go ahead. Keep the pace slow. You don't want to swing quick. We don't want momentum. We want to let the muscle do the pulling. Last one. Stand up. Change hands, change your feet. Same idea, good forward lean. Pull the elbow up, keep it tight to your side. Extend the weight back, go ahead. The less the elbow moves, the better. We're gonna get more tricep involved. If the elbow starts to move a lot, then we're gonna start using our back to assist. Grab a drink if you'd like. We're gonna do a series of ground exercises. So bring your weights, make your way down the ground. We'll start back up in about a minute. Start watching if you want to see what we're going to be doing. We're going to do an overhead pullover, so we're going to have bent knees, feet on the ground. We go straight up in the air with the weights. You don't have to get started yet. I'm just showing you what we're doing. Put the weights together. We're going to go up overhead, nice and slow. And pull back to the top. Okay, and then we're going to go back overhead. So one, two, come on down. Grab your weights, bring them in close by. You can usually go up to, you know, 8-10 pounds if you feel like you can handle a little bit heavier. I wouldn't go much more than 10 pounds though. Go bent knees. All right, let's line our back. Click the weights together, straight arms. We're gonna go nice and slow overhead. And go ahead, overhead slowly, keep the pace slow. Pull all the way back to the top, straight to the ceiling. Overhead, nice and slow. Back to the top. Two more. This one we're doing a 45 second round, last one. Good, bring the weights in, place those to the side. Next up, what we're gonna do is called a dead bug. So a dead bug, you have bent knees, you're gonna go straight up in the air with your arms. So your bent knees, up in the air, this is our start point, okay? We're gonna go opposite arm, opposite leg. They're gonna extend out. We're gonna pull them in. Before we go to the other side, we're gonna come all the way back. Then we can go to the other side. Extend them. Back to the top. We're just gonna go back and forth like so. Okay? So, here's our dead bug. Line your back, bent knees, arms go straight up. And here we go. Opposite arm, opposite leg. Extend them out. You can go as far as you want. If you can totally extend them, great. If you don't think you can, don't fully extend. Go to the other side, arm to the leg, and then the other side. All right, just gonna hold that rhythm back and forth. This is gonna be another 45 seconds. 10 seconds. And good, stop right there. We're gonna face towards the ground. This is almost like a dead bug. It's pretty much the same motion. We're just gonna do it opposite. So we're gonna face hands and knees. Call it bird dog. So we're gonna go hands and knees. We're gonna extend opposite arm, opposite leg. Bring it down, opposite arm, opposite leg. Here's a modified version. If this is not, if this is tough on the wrist or the knees or anything like that, you can always lie flat. You're gonna do opposite arm, opposite leg, like so. All right, but if you can, do hands and knees. We're going 5, 4, 3, 2, One. All right. Opposite arm, opposite leg. Opposite arm, opposite leg.
Some paths move so distant, and some spots move so light.
Okay, hold that rhythm. These are all 45 second rounds. You got 10 seconds to go. 3, 2, 1. Good. All right. Take a pause, lie on your back. You don't have to get started yet, but lie on your back, bring your weights in. You can rest them right on your body. We're going 10 seconds. This is an overhead pullover. So you're going to lie on your back, bent knees, grab your weights. We're going to go straight up in the air with the weights, click them together. And we go up overhead nice and slow. Then we're going to pull back to the top. All right, here we go. Go ahead. 45 seconds. Helps if you keep your core nice and tight. Keep your abs really tight. Keep the pace nice and slow, very slow.
And I wanna be honest with you, but so cold and so empty that you. Am I looking so ugly or looking stranger? Baby, I told you.
10 seconds. Gives us 3 more. 2 more. 1 more. Okay, bring the weights in, place those down to the side. This is the dead bug. So a dead bug takes a little coordination. We're going to pull the knees up, go up with that arm. We're going to go opposite arm, opposite leg. Pull back to the top, opposite arm, opposite leg, okay? So we're going to do it very slowly. Lie on your back, pull the knees up, arms go up, and here we go. Opposite arm, opposite leg. You can extend all the way out. If you don't think you can do that, then just go a little bit and then pull back in. Just keep the pace slow so you don't lose your rhythm. If you lose your rhythm, go back to the start point. That's with bent knees and arms straight up in the air. Then just try to reset your brain. Ten seconds. Three, two, one. Good. All right, let's face towards the ground. This is our bird dog. So bird dogs on hands and knees, or you can lie flat if you want a modified version. We go opposite arm, opposite leg. Opposite arm, opposite leg. All right, so we're going about 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Try to get a nice full extension if you can. You got 15 seconds to go. Five, four, three, two, one. Good. Coming down, lie on your back again. Bring your weights in, place them right on you. You can just hang out for about 15 seconds. We'll let everyone get set up on our backs again. Okay, so now we've got our weights, we're on our back, have some bent knees, straight up in the air, put the weights together. Here we go, slowly overhead. Seconds. Two more. Last one. All right, let's pull the weights in, place those down. We got two more to go. Next one's a dead bug. You're gonna stay on your back. You're gonna bend knees, arms go up in the air, opposite arm, opposite leg, opposite arm, opposite leg. All right, here we go, go ahead. Nice slow pace. Full extension if you can. If you don't think you can, just go a little bit shorter. You don't have to fully extend. 15 seconds. Three, two, one. All right. Take a pause. Face towards the ground. Hands and knees. You can lie flat on this one also. That would be your modified version. We're gonna go opposite arm, opposite leg extensions. We'll go in 5 seconds. Four, three, two, one. Here we go. Opposite arm, opposite leg. Opposite arm, opposite leg. Back and forth. 45 seconds. Yeah, as much as you can, don't twist the body when you do it. You want to keep everything facing towards the ground. 15 seconds to go. Four, three, two, one. All right, take a break. All right, good class, everyone. Thank you for coming.